ailing when it comes to Clark County, and the deep-reaching effect with its corruption against the innocent. And we're sick of it. The homeless now has a voice. It's a homeless helping the homeless. Operation Restore Order and God We Trust is real. We're not playing. Some people need to be held accountable. When you think that it's okay, whether it's a white, black, or whoever it is, or whatever problem they might have, that you're going to gun down innocent people. You're not getting away with that. It's not okay. Wear a badge, do it with honor. Be of the light, not of the darkness. And that's what this issue is. And you know it. Deep-rooted, deep-seated darkness in the state of Washington, sealed in satanic. And you know it is. Do the numerology, we know what it is. Why all the marriages are dying. Right? So, when it comes to the homeless, when it comes to people speaking out, when it comes to people that say, hey, look, I don't have an answer because I'm asking the police and they're not giving it to me. Well, obviously we're not getting heard. So I'll stand outside the building and see if anybody wants to have anything to say, because it looks like there's quite the presence of police force here tonight, isn't there? Right? So I don't need all the time that you have to give me. You know now that the homeless have a voice. It's the homeless helping the homeless. We don't need the city of Vancouver to try to step to do anything, stay off the porch, and realize that we're going to hold some people accountable. My name is David William Carpenter. Thank you. Amen.
We're here to show community opposition to the recent fatal shootings by Vancouver law enforcement agencies. Three fatal shootings in 3 weeks, which is not normal for Vancouver. Our demands are to require body cameras, dashboard cameras, ongoing de-escalation, cultural diversity, and mental health training. One of the main objectives has been privacy concerns, what has been a major pushback with this topic. Recently, Senate Bill 6408 passed nearly unanimously last year. This bill amended privacy issues with public record request objections and allowed exceptions as well, such as domestic violence. These issues addressed, they were resolved and can be found in three different RCWs found in the bill itself. In 2016, the Bureau of Justice reported about 63% of the general purpose law enforcement agencies that had acquired body-worn cameras had on average no public request for video footage per month, or had never received a request from public to obtain video generated from the cameras. We can also discuss Initiative 940, which was voted in an overwhelming majority last year. This initiative holds law enforcement accountable in situations where deadly force is used and added a required good faith standard. It will be difficult to judge if an officer used good faith where there is no evidence other than word of the officer and perhaps their colleagues to determine if the standard was met. This initiative should be used in concert with these pieces of technology to be fully sufficient. The Bureau of Justice also reports the most common reasons given to acquire body-worn cameras were to improve officer safety, improve evidence quality, reduce civilian complaints, and reduce agency liability. Arizona State University studies also found that officers with body-worn cameras were more productive in terms of making arrests, had fewer complaints lodged against them, and had a higher number of citizen complaints resolved in their favor. Officers with body-worn cameras said that they were more cautious in their interactions and sensitive to possible scrutiny of video footage by their superiors. Another objective has been cost. Pasco, Washington, a smaller city with less resources than Vancouver, has implemented cameras, and every officer there is expected to use them by the end of this month. They negotiated a $60,000 annual contract for both cameras and service with Axon, which is a leader in this industry. In conclusion, research provides that there are only benefits to requiring law enforcement officers to use these technological advancements. Surveys and studies both show the intent behind what the community is asking for is supported by the community and law enforcement itself. The objections commonly brought up by law enforcement have been defeated and remedies have been provided. We ask that these demands are met to benefit the community at large and to reestablish trust between the community and law enforcement in order to provide a better environment for everybody. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having the time this evening. I was with Michael Pierce when he was shot, and I had another 5 or 10 minutes with him. More, I believe he'd still be alive. The applicant created a line of fire toward the open health ministry when they advanced on it and decided in an offensive manner and then took a defensive position behind the tree and did not want to do CPR. He was immobilized, the gun was out of his hands. There was smoke coming out of his mouth. And they stood there leaving me to believe that they're either killers or cowards. Now, the one thing that is not being addressed, it seems that it's the number one, is the safety for the callers. And the police have gone out of the parameters of the law. More so than once, I have several examples. My mother was run over by the police because of this, and I got an out-of-order settlement from Vancover because of the ill-advised tactics and procedures that you can do because they can, and because it's convenient how they have separated themselves from other city and service workers and put themselves on another level and bring themselves back down from earth. They brought automatic assault rifles into a situation, into a community with people and children. This is not a combat war zone. This is a community with children. And they didn't take that in consideration, and they didn't set the situation at all with Michael Pierce, that he did not take a vision, he did not fire a gun once, and he was present himself. And one thing not only a gesture. I remained calm the entire time until after they shot him and did not proceed to give him CPR. I'm not going to bring that point up, but you cannot lead by example if you're going to go outside the parameters of the law. And that's what the police are doing and have done. If you stay inside the parameters of the law, the safety issues will not arise when they come onto scene and deal with situations. I've had secured their scenes more than once over the 25 years I've been here. A community member, I used to work at the Columbia under 9/11, and I'd also like to state to the Columbia newspaper, please do not put my name in the paper unless you did it correctly. You did it with all my permission, and if you had asked me first, you'd realize I used to work for you guys. Thank you. The police have gone beyond the point where their ego and vanity, their macho, bravado, would be the mold, and blinding them.
We will take a 5-minute break. It is 8:13. We will